From deep, Green. Offensive rebound, Pacers.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game, and even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
It's stolen by Lowry. You know, here we go. Lowry, nobody back. Lays it in off the breakaway.
And just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And Greg, those fans had a hand in the win. I mean, they gave this team a big lift throughout the game. I thought there was great energy in the building.
And so Toronto takes this one. But by
that was terrible. That was terrible. That was, oh, I lose VC. That was terrible.
Many thanks, Kevin. So now we move on to our Jordan player of the game, Jonas Valanciunas. During the second half, it seemed like he was simply on a mission.
Man, I don't really didn't let up. Damn about Jonas
Valanciunas. And that's it for our broadcast here tonight. But we're just getting started on a new season in the NBA. For Shaquille O'Neal.
That was a debacle. I should not be 8 in the morning. I really shouldn't. Oh, God damn. I just fucking five. Sorry, what the hell was I thinking? What was I doing? I need to, like, get some sleep. I really should. But it's already saved, so there's nothing I can do. It's done with. It's over with and done. My boy Dustin Green, first game, fucking it up. Somebody finna be talking shit. Oh, okay, cool. Green, what you been doing, man? Alright, let me learn this dude's shot area. Yeah, see, yup, it's all, I knew it was gonna be different. Oh, okay, so let's see, how far out can he shoot this ball? Alright, arc up. Okay. So. Huh. Really, niggas? Really, niggas? The Cavs? Y'all gonna put me on Kyrie?
LeBron James. What more can you say about the guy that hasn't already been said? He can play anywhere on the court, and he gets it done on both ends like nobody else in the league. If we can't slow him down, this game could get out of hand real quick. It's gonna be one of the biggest tests of the season for me, that's for sure. Time to step up.
Kyrie better still be injured. Like, this better be realism. Like, he better still be on that motherfucking bench. Because if Kyrie in the game, I'm calling bullshit. They trying to catch a nigga on a motherfucking humbug. And I don't feel like I want to deal with that. Wait. Shumpert. Miles, no, Shumpert, Love, LeBron, come on, show me the line, I don't care about the Pacers, I don't care about none of them, man, at least I ain't go to fuck, alright, wait, no, why the fuck is he, no, why he got a jumpsuit, oh, come on, man,
the
Cavaliers have an Eastern Conference contest on their hands as they prepare to defend their home court here at the Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland. It's the NBA.
Motherfuckers ain't shit.
Here's James. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Philadelphia.
And was a force on the defensive side as well. Four steals over the course of that game.
And for LeBron James, a remarkable stat. Greg, he had increased his field goal percentage for seven consecutive seasons going into 2014.
Yeah, a steep decline last season, though, back below 50%. Was it just the challenge of new teammates and a new system? Or the mileage he's accumulated. This season may start to
I was planted. Out you, motherfucker.
Courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here's a peek at the league's top scorers from a season ago. LeBron James third.
And looking back, his points per game really underscore the fact that he never took a game off. I mean, one special performance after another all season long.
Irving kicks to Thompson. Some nice passing by Cleveland here. Those three-pointers off the mark.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. Really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
That free throw good from Thompson.
And one thing about Tristan Thompson, he is an absolute terror on the offensive glass. Was top five in that category last year, despite playing less than 27 minutes. Again, does a terrific job with anticipation of the carom and uses his gigantic wingspan to just go up and reel it in.
Now I know that I'm not going to be shooting shit. I'm not shooting shit. I'm shooting. I'm passing straight dimes. None but dimes, man. What you doing, star shit?
Verigeau dishes to Smith.
Why is it like?
Smith's got his first 3 points of the game. Greg, you were talking about Tristan Thompson. LeBron came out and said
that bullshit.
He's one of the best pick-and-roll defenders in the NBA. And, Clark, that's high praise from the King.
No doubt. I mean, Thompson is an emerging force. If he could just develop his shooting stroke a little more, then you're talking about a very, very valuable play.
Good point. Here's Irving. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Irving's got his second bucket of the game to go.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Yeah, they're lasered in. I mean, really making the most of their possessions.
Green against Irving. Green kicks to Stuckey. Six on the shot clock. Up and in, off to an efficient start. Two for three from the field.
The defender a little hesitant to offer resistance as he bursts to the hoop.
See,
the
Cavaliers not even going to shoot. Not even gonna waste my time. Oh, shit. He's supposed to be injured. He is supposed to be fucking injured.
Defensively, they've been a step slow here to start.
Giving up too many open shots. I mean, that's what's happening here, Greg. They look to me to be a bit sluggish.
And stolen by Kyrie Irving.
Come on, man.
Drops in the breakaway lane. He's got eight.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they've just given them too many looks inside.
Yeah, and usually when a team goes on a run like this, it's because they are getting too many opportunities on the inside. Make them beat you from deep.
The drive by Hill. Jefferson with some nice deep.
And trying to come up with a highlight reel finish. Somebody forgot to finish it.
The first quarter concludes in a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. Cleveland ahead. As they end the first quarter on a 12-4 run. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena. And Cavs head coach David Blatt beginning his NBA career after a long and illustrious career coaching over in Europe. He talked about the difference coaching abroad.
There's just a lot more practice time. And when the games come, you're still playing two, maximum three times a week. You know, here you could be playing four or five times a week, and your practice time is going to be limited, and your ability to change things is going to be limited. You know, adjustments can and will be made and should be made, but you got to be a lot more pointed.
And Blatt, one of the most successful American coaches in European basketball history, Clark, and he's done a great job in his first season with the Cavaliers in the NBA, but nothing he did overseas certainly can compare to this.
And, you know, that's why, Kevin, people always talk about it in terms of being a marathon and not a sprint.
Here in the second quarter.
Come on, man. Why?
Cavs were one of the top teams in the East last year, and it was in large part to how strong they were at home.
What, did they shoot it well from beyond the arc at home, Kevin? I mean, top three in the league in terms of three-point shooting. It does help to have LeBron, doesn't it?
It does. That is a factor. Mahini passes to Miles. Just five to shoot. Here's Stuckey. That's good, and he's now 3 for 4 from the field.
That is an elegant move to drop in the floater there, guys.
Outside Irving. Outside Jefferson. Trying to find Thompson. He gets it to him. Back to Jefferson. Green against Irving. Outside for Jefferson. That's a 2 from Smith. And again, it's Cleveland.
That's how you extend the lead.
They torching our ass,
man. I mean, they have
man.
Tremendous confidence going for them right now. And that confidence is leading to some excellent shooting.
Green against Irving. Green dishes to Mahini. Green with a screen on Thompson. Out of bounds. Cleveland takes possession.
Are you serious?
Now, when you think of the great playmakers in the
are you fucking
John
serious?
Stockton per game averaged double-digit dimes. Think of this. For his career, 15.
Are you serious? I set up that screen
assists
for you to go to the hole.
You knew right
and you,
for a very long time.
And, guys, you know, you look up point guard in the dictionary, and there's a nice little picture of John Stockton there. I mean, he is an unreal distributor. Controlled the game like no one ever has before or since. It's no coincidence that Utah never missed the playoffs in any of the 19 seasons that John Stockton was at the helm.
And Indiana making a change here. Hills checked in. The drive by Green. It's stolen by Jefferson. Irving kicks to Thompson. Can't hit. Pacers have gone 6-12 in the second quarter, right at the 50% mark from the field. Here's Green. Can't get it to go. And Cleveland the other way now, coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
And that was a stinker. I mean, that's one of those games where you really can't find anything that they did well. The game just got out of hand and really just a shaky performance across the board.
Yeah, and I'd have to agree with you. And you know how optimistic and positive I am. But it's hard for me to find anything positive to take away from that. That's a game you just want to forget about as soon as you can.
And it's Smith again missing.
The right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of his comfort zone. Whoa, quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great seat.
Coach finna chew us the fuck out. Coach finna...
This shit finna be funny as hell. Oh, shit.
Okay, pay attention so we can cover some stuff. We're capable of much better basketball than we played in the first half. If things are gonna change next half, we have to get our guys in the low post more involved. Let's get better entry passing, and let's get our elbows dirty once the ball's in there. There's a lot more.
We're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third.
Coach S.
What a great game for Love in this. He's got 14 points, and he's chalked up one three-pointer on the day as well.
And, Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of